Hello, everyone, and welcome once again. This is sort of my continuation on my scientific education video that I did a little while ago. And this part is actually going to be split into two pieces. This is the evolution versus intelligent design part that I promised you all. Now, before I get started, I have a sort of little bit of a disclaimer to tell you all. I am an agnostic person. I am not an atheist, that is to say, I do not say there is no God. Rather, I say if you are religious, if you believe in a God or gods, whatever it happens to be, that's fine with me, but keep it where it belongs. Our Constitution guarantees separation of church and state, blah, 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 blah. I'm going to talk all about that. But that's my disclaimer, okay? It's not that I don't believe in any God, it's that I think that there is a place for religion. And in this particular case, I'm going to be talking about religion in schools in the sense of teaching intelligent design as part of evolution, essentially. What I'm doing is I'm splitting this video into two pieces. The first is going to be the education aspect of putting intelligent design into classrooms. The second will be me looking at intelligent design as a creation theory, and what they say about it, and what makes sense and what doesn't, okay? So to get us started, I'll just briefly mention that intelligent design itself has not existed for very long, because originally it was creationism. Contrary to what many, 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 many people will say, creationism and intelligent design are completely and utterly interwoven. You cannot have one without the other. Intelligent design, in the end, is creationism, therefore it is based on religion. It was in about the middle of 1987 that intelligent design, as a term for this, really started to gain ground. And it was actually with a textbook called On Pandas and People. Okay? This textbook was specifically designed to really slam evolution and say this doesn't make any sense, God is the only way, and he created all things as they are right now, okay? So that was the really big time when intelligent design came into being, and basically the take-home is that we started off with creationism and nothing but, and then moved from that to a lot more of intelligent design, okay? One of the biggest, I guess, sort of complaints that a lot of religious people will have with evolution is the fact that everybody says evolution is a theory. It is the theory of evolution by natural selection. Makes sense, right? The problem with this is that it is a scientific theory. And a lot of people do not understand what a theory means in a scientific context. You know that we have the law of gravity. We know that gravity exists. We know how it works, okay? We have the theory of evolution, and the idea that the Earth goes around the sun is actually a theory. Would you go against the theory of a heliocentric universe or a heliocentric solar system now? No, you wouldn't, but it is still a scientific theory. A scientific theory being a hypothesis, an idea that has a great, great, great deal of evidence around it, supporting it, that has been gathered over years and years and years and decades, and has either very little or no evidence to the contrary. That is what evolution is. It is a scientific theory. It has a great deal, it has a mountain of evidence that is a proponent of it, and very little, if any, evidence against it. Okay? I will talk about some of the evidence against evolution in my next video when I talk about what intelligent design is and all that kind of stuff. So, don't worry. All right? Like I said, this time I really want to focus more on the idea of education, school board votes, all that kind of stuff, with trying to bring, not evolution, but bringing either intelligent design into the classroom or, frankly, just taking evolution out. Okay, there have been a couple of different ways of doing this. Amongst them, several states, namely, check my notes real quick, Texas, Minnesota, New Mexico, Pennsylvania, Missouri, South Carolina, and Alabama all have laws on the books that say in their science curricula that they are to, quote, analyze key aspects of evolutionary biology and essentially criticize it. So basically, you're looking at evolution as a process and saying, hey, what's wrong with this? What doesn't make sense? Well, that's good. That's nice because it lets kids do critical thinking. But the thing is, it's only there because of these religious idealists. Okay? There is barely any, if any, evidence at all that evolution is not occurring. We actually can observe evolution happening, believe it or not. But there are several relatively large groups that are really hard against evolution, and obviously most of these being very religious groups. There is one institute in particular called the Discovery Institute, which is all about proponents of intelligent design, spreading the word, doing research, all that kind of stuff. Okay? So, with that, both Mississippi and Louisiana also have laws on the books, although, thankfully, at least again in my opinion, thankfully, Louisiana's laws were just overturned on this aspect, where teachers are allowed to bring in additional materials for their students to learn about the origin of life. Okay? So in other words, they can bring in additional materials to show their children, whatever it happens to be. Okay? So here's the big issue that I have right here. I mentioned a little while ago that intelligent design and creationism are like this. They're buddy buddies. You can't get them separated. It doesn't happen. The whole principle behind intelligent design is that there is an intelligence. There is a higher being that is designing everything on Earth. That is creationism. And the problem comes when you're teaching it in public schools. Private schools, I have no problem with. If you want to teach it at your private school, your private university, Sunday schools, whatever you want, you can teach as much intelligent design and creationism as you want. But as soon as you cross the line into the public schools where my taxes and your taxes are paying for, that is a problem because it's against our Constitution. Because that is clearly going into a specific religion and saying that this is their creationist idea, okay? All religions have their own creation ideas. I bet that if we had, let's say, Hindu creation coming in, then Christians would probably be pretty upset about that if it got into schools. But not about intelligent design, because that is their version of it, okay? Once again, I don't want to bash any religions at all. I am perfectly fine with religions. You can do whatever you want in your church, your temple, your synagogue, whatever it happens to be. That's fine with me. I have nothing against God. I have nothing against religion or religious people. My problem is the public schools. If you get federal, state, local, whatever it is, funding that is paid by taxes, paid by the people, then that goes against the Constitution, okay? As I'm sure most of you know, this has been to court several times, okay? Amongst them was a decision that was made back in 2005, and it was the Kitzmiller versus the Dover School District, all right? So this is actually one of the biggest decisions in terms of this, I guess you can call it a fight, of evolution versus intelligent design. And in this case, this decision specifically said that intelligent design is attempting to establish a religious portion, a religious thing within public schools, which is not constitutional. And in addition, intelligent design is not at all considered an area of science on this. But people are still pining to get these things changed and to get more and more intelligent design and creationists taught in schools. Part of the issue becomes then that we have a lot of consequences for our students. For example, if you want to get into college and you want to take a college science class, you better know evolution. You better know taxonomy. You have to know this stuff. The problem is that the way that some schools are dealing with these issues is they're just getting rid of the origin of species altogether. They're completely eliminating the talks about the origin of life because it's just easier, because they don't have to deal with intelligent design or creationism and all these people who are going against evolution, okay? And on that note, one of the things that people are trying to do is establish evolution as a religion, because therefore it wouldn't be allowed in schools either. The problem with that is evolution is not religion. It is a scientific theory that makes sense if you read all the evidence for it. It makes sense. It is logical. It is scientific. We have all of these missing links between us and the apes. We have DNA data. We have structures. We have bone structure data. We have migration data. All of this stuff represents evolution, change over time. Intelligent design doesn't account for most of that. So there's a lot of different ways that people are attacking evolution, and it's really unfortunate because it means that our students are suffering because colleges and universities are expecting them to know this stuff. And if they don't know it, if they don't know the scientific evidence for it, then they'll do worse in school. Not only that, but you have to think, this has gone to court many, many, many times in many different states. How much do you think it costs these schools in litigation? These schools can't afford to basically get sued because of something they should be teaching versus something they should not be teaching because it's unconstitutional. And who suffers? The kids. They can't get new supplies. They can't get new computers. They can't get lab equipment. They can't get new books. They can't get anything because they're spending all their money on these litigations that are completely pointless because it doesn't do anybody any good. And what are we left with? We're left with a bunch of school districts that are underfunded, have poor tests, poor test scores, students who don't care or don't know or don't care to know. And you have a bunch of people who are yelling and screaming because kids are learning about science, a genuine scientific theory that has been accepted by the vast, vast, vast majority of everybody. There have been polls done, certainly. There have been several polls done on whether or not intelligent design should be taught alongside evolution. Now, these have been met with varying results. If you remember, I mentioned the Discovery Institute not too long ago, which is an intelligent design proponent. It is the Intelligent Design Institute. They actually performed a poll that said, should we teach this either by itself, evolution with intelligent design, evolution alongside the evidence against evolution, etc., etc. And in that poll, a vast majority of people, I believe it was almost 7 out of 10 people, said, oh, we should teach evolution alongside the evidence that goes against evolution. You know what the problem with that is? There is no evidence against it. We have not found solid evidence that goes against evolution. It doesn't exist. The problem is when the Discovery Institute is asking these questions, people assume, oh, there's evidence against evolution. We better teach our kids that just in case. That's the problem. If you go to some of these other polls, though, some of the polls that are done by, I don't want to say reputable places, but I guess more third-party objectivist places, then we say that about 29% of people believe that public schools should teach evolution in science class, but you can discuss creationism as a belief, not as an alternative, but as a belief. 20% said that public schools should only teach evolution. 17 thought that public schools can teach both of them, but evolution is in science and religion is elsewhere, say electives, things like that. 16% thought that public schools should teach only creationism, and 13% said that you should get both in science class. Now, for those of you who didn't quite get that, that's 29 plus 20 is 49 plus another 17 is 66% of people said that evolution should be the only origin of species theory taught in science classes. It's fine if you mention creationism, but don't teach it as science. And if you're wondering, that is a poll from 2000 by People for the American Way. And they asked a bunch of random people, and that is what they found. So, in summary, keep intelligent design out of schools. Not schools. Keep it out of science. Because it's not science. You can't test it. I'm going to talk about that later. Okay? Keep it in your private schools. Keep it in your Sunday schools. Keep it in your religious buildings, whatever it happens to be. Keep it where it belongs. Keep it out of my science class. Because it doesn't belong there, and our schools can't afford to fight you. Because there's no point. Just leave it alone and let us do our job and teach our kids. And with that, I'll say goodbye until my next video, where, like I said, I'll go a little bit deeper into the intricacies of some of the minor problems with evolution, as well as some of the things that intelligent design is known for. So, thank you very much for watching. My brother the head, my brother the head. I received the photos you sent, and I don't regret that I went. Or the sight of everybody still. My brother the ape, my brother the ape.